So far, we've been solving homogeneous linear second order differential equations. Homogeneous means that there's a zero on the right hand side. In this video, I want to show you the theory behind solving second order inhomogeneous differential equations. So let's do the general second order equation. So linear. So we have x double dot plus some function of t, p of t, times x dot, plus some function of t, q of t, times x. And then here we have a non-zero right-hand side, so I'll call that g of t. So how do we solve this inhomogeneous differential equation? In fact, there's a three-step method. Of course, to have a unique solution, we also need two initial conditions. So I should write that here. So we have x of 0 equals x naught, and x dot of 0 equals u naught. Okay, so the three-step method. The first step is to first solve the homogeneous equation. So step one is solve the homogeneous equation. Right? That means the equation where g of t equals 0. Here we're just going to find the general solution to the homogeneous equation. Remember that the general solution has two functions with non-zero Wronskian, right? So you can satisfy the initial condition. And they're multiplied by constants. So the homogeneous solution will look something like a constant times x1 of t plus another constant times x2 of t. Okay? It's very important that the homogeneous solution has two free constants. Step two is to find the particular solution which is the solution of the inhomogeneous differential equation, and it's basically any solution of the inhomogeneous differential equation. So what we have to do here is find some x that when you substitute it into the left-hand side of this equation, you end up with g of t. So this is called the particular solution. So this will be x p of t. Okay? So part of the lectures in this section will be to show you how to find particular solutions of constant coefficient second order equations where the right hand side is a trig function, a sine or a cosine, or an exponential function or a polynomial. Okay, so that's the first two steps. The third step then is to write the general solution of this differential equation, x of t, as the sum of the homogeneous solution plus the particular solution. Okay? When we do that, we add these two solutions. We can then use the two free constants in the homogeneous solution to satisfy the two initial conditions. So here then, finally, we need to determine C1 and C2 from the initial conditions. Okay? So that's the three-step process. Solve the homogeneous equation, find the general solution to the homogeneous equation, find the particular solution, xp of t. It will be the x that when you substitute it into the left-hand side, you get g of t. Then write the general solution of the inhomogeneous differential equation as the sum of the homogeneous solution and the particular solution, finally determines C1 and C2 from the initial conditions. So why does this work, right? So why is this x of t a solution of the inhomogeneous equation? So we can try, we can substitute in, right? So let me do that. So if we have x double dot plus p times x dot plus q times x, and we substitute in our form for x, that will be equal to the second derivative, right, of x. So we have xh double dot plus xp double dot plus our p of t, right? This p in the subscript means particular solution. This p here means a function of time, right? This p times x dot, so that will be xh dot plus x sub p dot, plus q times x, so plus q times xh plus xp, right? And if we group the terms here, we have an xh double dot plus a p xh dot plus a q xh, right? That's the xh double dot plus p of t times xh dot plus q of t times xh plus the other grouping of terms, xp, the particular solution, double dot, plus p of t times xp dot plus q of t times xp. And then finally, what do we have? We have the differential equation for the homogeneous solution. That's zero, right? So when you put the homogeneous solution into the differential equation, you get zero because you're solving the zero equation. So this is zero. And then the differential equation for the particular solution, that's equal to g. Okay, which is just g of t. So our sum of the homogeneous solution plus the particular solution solves the inhomogeneous equation, because when you substitute in, the homogeneous solution goes to zero and the particular solution goes to g of t. Okay, it works out because the equation is a linear equation in x. Okay, so let me summarize. To solve the inhomogeneous equation, we're going to use a three-step process. In the first step, we're going to find the general solution of the homogeneous equation, setting the right-hand side equal to zero. In the second step, we're going to use some type of ansatz to determine an x such that when you substitute it into the left-hand side, you get g. All you need is one function that satisfies the substituting into the differential equation part, you get g. That's what we call the particular solution. Then the general solution is written as the homogeneous solution plus the particular solution. This general solution contains two free constants. The two free constants come from the homogeneous solution. Finally, we use the initial conditions to determine those two free constants. We'll be working several examples with different types of g of t. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.